Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy. Just got a bunch of original Columbia cylinders from eBay. Picked these up fairly cheap, brown wax originals, and black wax, of course. But the early Columbias are essentially brown wax, even though they are black in color. But this is what they look like usually when you get them. Now, these are original brown wax. These are 1900, 1901, 1902. Extremely old, and as you can see, extremely moldy. So what we're going to do is shave them. I started shaving this one, and I decided I'd do a video and document it to give you an idea of what they can look like after you shave them. Remember, this is what it looks like when you start. Now, this one was particularly bad, which is why I'm shaving this one first. So let's see what kind of progress we can make in turning this into a recording blank. The point, of course, is to try to remove as much of the mold as we can to get a smooth recording surface and get it back to brown wax again. Taking little tiny cuts. Looks like we're making some progress. The cylinder is loose on the mandrel. Let's see how we're doing so far. Okay, just a couple of spots, and we're going to have a usable blank here, I think. Of course, the nice thing about this is these are original cylinders. And I'm trying to take off the minimum amount of material to leave the blank as big as it can possibly be and still remove the mold. Alright, getting down to brown wax.
one more pass.
And now we'll do a couple passes without adjusting the color, the cutter, just to smooth the surface out. Let's see how we did. Still the slightest bit on the center. And a bit there. So we can go a bit deeper, but as I said, I try to keep these as large as possible and taking off the minimum amount of material required just to remove the mold. But you can see substantial difference between what it was and what it is. So let's give it one more good pass here. Make sure that's good and snug on the mandrel. All right. And one more slight cut. And now we'll just smooth the surface. You know, as I said, if you do any serious recording on an Edison machine, you have to have a shaver. It is absolutely essential. All right, let's see what it looks like. Because without a shaver, you really can't do much at all. Still a couple of small spots of mold. Nothing major. But you're still going to hear that. So, as I said, I try to shave the minimum amount possible. But this is going to take another couple of cuts to get that absolutely smooth. Of course, what you have to be careful of is in removing the mold, you want to make sure that you don't remove so much material that you can't record on it anymore. Sometimes this mold goes really deep. And I'm going to give this one more cut, and then we'll put it on the machine and see how noisy it is. And one more, we'll call it done. Alright, now a couple cuts to smooth it. And I've got the machine running at about half speed. Take a look. Well, that's looking pretty good. Considering what it looked like before. All right, let's swing the camera around. Let's see how noisy or quiet it is. We shall see. Well, some noise, but nothing major. About the same all the way across. You know, and the nice thing about this, of course, is the fact this is an original cylinder. And even though it still has a bit of noise on it, it will still make a very effective recording blank. And again, the nice thing about it is it's original. You can still see some flecks of mold, and that's where most of the noise is coming from. You can never get them completely smooth. Well, I can't say that. 90% of the time, you're always going to have some noise because this mold, as you can see, goes completely through the cylinder. But they're available, they're reasonably inexpensive, it's completely inaudible, so as a cylinder, as an original cylinder, it's virtually worthless because you could not hear it. And it was covered, absolutely covered with mold. And now it is at least a usable blank, and what you have is an original, in this case, 1900 cylinder that's now ready to be recorded on. So it's really gratifying to be able to take one of these cylinders that is absolutely useless. Now I've got 12 of these. And there's the black one. Let me grab another brown one. And these are a mix of Edison and Columbia cylinders. And as you can see, the before and after is actually quite dramatic. And there is no way you can listen to this. All you hear is the mold. It's just solid noise, inside and outside. But if you have the shaver, you can take one of these worthless old cylinders and actually turn it into a fairly decent recording blank that is, as I said, original. So anyway, I just wanted to do a quick video. These just got here, and I wanted to see how they would work after I shaved them. Obviously, they have a bit of noise, but still, I'm going to be able to record on these, and, you know, these are original 1900 cylinders, so the cylinder is 112 years old. Quite amazing. So, if you have any questions, comments, feel free to drop me a line, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. I answer all my email. I'll try to answer them the day I get them. And if you have any of these cylinders, I pay $4 a piece for cylinders that are sometimes more than that, depending on the condition of them. But moldy cylinders that you can't play anymore, or early black wax, they don't have to be brown, early black wax cylinders are the same. Between $4 and $6 a piece, and I turn them into recording blanks. I also offer a shaving service, so if you have a bunch of these, you can send them to me, I can shave them, and send them back, and you have a supply of recording blanks of your own. So in any case, any questions, comments, drop me a line, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.